Hi everyone, welcome to the first of my free music software guides. My name is Oscar, I'm a musician from Porto, Portugal, and I decided to start this new YouTube series of free music software guides because we are back again in a lockdown. So hopefully some of you can find this helpful and make some music while you stay at home. On the first video, Groove Pizza. So this video has mainly three sections. The first one is a tutorial. I'll show you the controls on the website, how to get around things, how to make music with it. On the second, we'll make some examples such as these ones. And on the third one, I'll give you some activity suggestions for using the app. So let's get started. So here's Groove Pizza. The link is also in the description below or on this bar right here or in the screen right now. It's apps.muselab.org/groovepizza/. So it's a web-based drum programming and drum sequencer app. Here's what you look at when you first open the website. It should look a lot like this. Obviously, if you're on a mobile device, it will sound a bit different. There should be like a cogwheel where you can click to access these settings here on the bottom left corner, but the pizza itself and the map should look the same. If you click on the upper left corner on the Groove Pizza icon, you can see that it was created at the New York University Music Experience Design Lab. So click on that and have a look at the guys behind it. It's an amazing piece of software. It was built originally in Ethan Hines' master thesis. So yeah, kudos to them. Fine example of music software. I don't know about you, but when I see a play button on the website, I always want to click that. So let's do that. So you can already start having a feel of what it does. The pizza part comes obviously from the circle. And it's a circle because it's looping, meaning it's going clockwise from 1 to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 16. And when it reaches 16, it goes back to 1 and repeats all over again. In traditional music notation, maybe you have something closer to this. The numbers in a straight line from left to right, 1 to 16. So the pizza itself, it's this part here, and it has 16 slices. Why 16? Because 16 is the number of 16th notes on a traditional 4-4 bar. If you don't know what that is, don't panic. Be sure to tune in to the next episode of the Free Music Software Guide. We'll talk a lot about that. But basically, it has four beats, the one starting on 1, another on 5, another on 9, another on 13. It's like north, south, west, and east, of course. And each one of them is subdivided by 4. So you have 1E and, 2E and, 3E and, 4E and. That's a general feel. So 16 slices on this pizza, and each of them has like 3 layers. The outer layer is a kick drum sound. So if you notice, there are 2 dots on the outer layer, one on 15 and another on 1. That's why you have 2 sounds on each loop. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. You have, so you see on 15 and 1, you have those sounds. If I click on 9, on the outer layer of 9, check it out. Now we have a triangle, because we have 3 dots, of course. Have a listen. So 3 kick drum sounds on each loop makes a triangle. If I click here on the 7, something funny will happen, which is, now we have a rectangle. What does this mean? It means that we have 4 sounds. And by the way, if you click on this angle icon right here, you can see it's a 90 degree angle. It's a fun way to teach maths to children, for instance, or to adults like me. Okay. But it also means more than that, because this rectangle obviously has its sides. Two of them are equal to one another. So this side here is equal to this side right here. And this side here is equal to that side right there. What does this mean? It means that it takes the same amount of time to get from 1 to 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then a hit. Then it takes from 9 to 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then a hit, okay? The same thing here, it's just they are 3/16 notes apart, so it's also a fun way to teach geometry to children. Okay, so the outermost layer is obviously a kick drum. The innermost layer is a hi-hat sound. Let's put a nice figure right here. It's this high-pitched sound, and on the middle layer you have a snare drum. So that's the basic way of composing using Groove Pizza. If you click on the icon here, the drum kit icon, it will change the sound. It's a techno kit right now, but if you click on the rock kit, okay. Also, Afro Latin doesn't have like the logic of kick, snare, and but rather of low pitched sound, medium range pitch sound, and high pitched sound. But it's the same rhythm, you know, just only the samples, the sound samples are changing. So you can explore that as you wish. You also have these controls. It's very easy to explain. I've mentioned the angles. This one here is just the fill, so it only draws lines if the fill is not selected. Obviously, the volume is self-explanatory. Softer and louder. The BPM is the tempo, faster, slower. Now the swing has to do with the 16th note swing. I'll put the hi-hat in and be sure to check the swing. Basically, the more, the higher the value, the more uneven, meaning that in straight fill, which is what you have right now with the swing in zero, all of the 16th notes are the same, and the more you raise it, the more they swing. The number of slices is a way of changing the time signature, basically. So if you put it on 15, actually I'll change it mid performance. Check it out. So it's a way of changing the number of slices on the pizza, and obviously the number of repetitions in the loop, of course. So that's the basic thing side of it. That's the basic tutorial. Also, you can click here to add different figures that you can change, like this. It will play these figures from left to right, starting here. This, then this, then this, then this. Back to one. So you can have a musical phrase made of four different loops, four different pizzas. That's basically about it. So that's the end of section one. On to section two. So here on section two, I've started from scratch, meaning I did a new project. And it's time for us to look at the shapes right here at the left side of the screen. You have these shapes, for instance, a triangle. You can put it right there. Have a listen. One thing I really like is that if you click and drag, you can rotate only the layer, like only the kick drum layer, for instance, or only the hi-hat layer, okay? You can also do it in real time. Let's add a square. And then a second figure where it has a pentagon and the kick, and then octagon on the hi-hat. Pretty cool, huh? Also, if you really want to have some fun, they have some specials, Jeff's specials right here. This one is very cool, but it's a very straightforward one. So it's the groove from Billie Jean. You have many different ones. Of course, this one is also very simple. We will Rock You by Queen. Maybe more like this. This trap one is very cool. It has four different shapes, completely different, so you have a more complex rhythm going from the first one to the fourth. Have a listen. Pretty cool, huh? So yeah, that's the end of section two. Let's go on to section three. So here on the third section, I've started all over again, and I have some activities I'd like to suggest you. The first one is very simple, is to make your own song or music or whatever. You can just play around with it, but I'll show you a quick cool little trick with this website, which is when you do your own rhythm and you're happy with it, you can actually share it. You can download it as audio. So if I click here, it will download a WAV file. You can also share it on Twitter and Facebook. If you want me to check, just send it to me and I'll be glad to see your own compositions. And you have the share link. The share link is very useful because each time you start a session on Groove Pizza, it will create a unique ID. So if I cut and paste this same link, it will open the session as it is. So imagine you're working and you're doing a bit with a friend. You can send him the link, him or her the link, and they can continue just working on it. So the first activity is very simple, is make your own rhythms. That's about it. Now for the second activity, let's start with a plain one. The second activity I'd like to suggest is for you to play the rhythms you make. How so? Well, of course, maybe you don't have a drum kit at home, but you have your own body. You can use body percussion. For instance, the kick drum can be the chest sound. The snare drum, the middle sound, can be the clap. And the hi-hat can be finger snaps. So I'll try and build a rhythm right here that only uses a sound for each slice. You don't have to fill in all the slices, obviously, but I'll try and do that. And I'll start with a pretty basic pattern, such as this one. Doom, Let me slow it down a bit. So it's a very, very simple one. It has a kick on the one and the third beat as well, on also on the middle of the third beat, and then a snare on 2 and 4, meaning 5 and 13 in terms of slices. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. So try and practice that, replacing the kick sound with the chest sound and the clap sound, and the snare sound with the clap sound, and then you can fill in all the blanks with hi-hats, like this. So what I did was, in each slice that was empty, I put in a hi-hat sound. Sounds like this. So here's how I would practice it. Have a look. So the way I'd practice this rhythm is by starting very slow and be very mindful of which hand you use for the snap and the clap and the chest. So like this. Just practice it like a choreography. If you notice, I used my right hand for the chest and, well, I was snapping with the left. These kinds of things are matter, and when you're comfortable, just speed it up. Like that. So obviously you can do that with your own sounds. Make your own musical phrases and practice with your body. I think it's very important for us to learn how to use our body and to just get some very good quality sounds out of it. Just by clapping, there's so much you can learn by learning how to clap properly in a performative way that it's amazing. So these two activities should keep you very, very busy. And these are my suggestions to you. Thank you. So, thanks a lot for watching. I had lots of fun recording this video and showing you how to use Groove Pizza. Make sure to check their website and give them a thanks as well. They did an amazing work with this app. And hope to see you next time. So yeah, see you soon. Three, two,